Hello everyone, hello and happy moment wherever you are. Thanks for joining. I'm Jennifer from Personal Power Life Coaching, and I would love to share in this video some of the insights that I have garnered from this magnificent day. I am making this video at the end of my business day, and I just felt inspired and compelled to share some of the things that came across my desk today. And one of the main things that I have been really picking up on these past few days, and which is actually intrinsic to the life coaching paradigm, is to, in every situation where you are faced with something that could be considered a problem, or an issue, or some area that you're working on improving, the key is to focus on what you do want and what your desired outcome is. So the reason that we focus on the outcome is because we can set ourselves a goal and a target, an objective of what we do want and what would be the preferable situation for us. So if you find yourself perhaps in any moment in time where you're facing an issue or you want to fix something, ask yourself, I know what I don't want, so what is it that I do want? What is my outcome? What is my objective and outcome from this conversation, from this meeting, from this gym session, from this outing, whatever it is, what is your outcome? So focus on that so that you have a better sense and a vision and a target for yourself. And that informs your subconscious mind immediately as to how to orient itself and what to look for, and then what actions to take so that it can lead you ultimately in that direction. And another point that I wanted to highlight that is related to this one, number one, this is number two, which is to talk more about what you do want. Once you have clearly identified what your outcome is and what your desired objective is, talk about or focus on thinking of what you do want and how you wish to feel, how you prefer to be living or feeling in that moment, and how good it would be. For instance, I saw one woman today who was experiencing intense shoulder pain, and I was suggesting some nutrition tips as well as yoga movements. And hello to everyone who's watching. Lots of love. And what I noticed is that another woman came in and they were chatting, and this woman, the one that I was counseling, she just kept bringing up the point of the pain, the intense pain, the pain at night. And I heard the same comments several times. And I couldn't help but mention to her, you know, ma'am, in addition to doing these types of interventions to help yourself nutritionally, talk more about what you do want, and don't talk so much about the pain, and don't talk about it with everyone. Don't talk about it as much as you can, because it was all that she was talking about. It was just the pain, and you could see the emotion, you could see the intensity of feeling, you could see the full vividness of her experience, and it was almost like she's reliving that pain, which only comes at night, and then the other person takes on that reality, and then they talk about it with her, and then when they see her again, they're going to talk about it again and ask her, how's that pain? How's that pain? So I suggested to her to consider not talking so much about it, because the more you talk about something that's a problem or an issue, the more real it becomes, the stronger it becomes in your mind, in your reality, and you give it more life. And it becomes more, it just becomes stronger, and it becomes more. And suddenly that's all you can see, and you forget that there is a solution and that there is something better out there. Okay, so focus on what you do want and don't talk so much about the problem. Don't bring it up so much. Even if it bothers you and it's a, you know, you feel that pain or the relationship is going through problem or something is rubbing you the wrong way, absolutely don't feed it the negative energy. Feed it with the good intentions and the positive direction and focus of what you do want and where you do want to go. And this will also send messages to other people who are hearing you, and they will understand, oh, well, this is what this lady wants. Well, that could be nice. Gee, I wonder how that would feel. And one thing to bear in mind is that if you talk about the good things with people who will doubt it, then they're going to doubt it. So rather than sharing that with individuals who will not be so supportive, choose wisely with whom you share your energy and your intentions. And most important is that you be clear about this with yourself. As some other life coaches have said, and I think I heard it from Tony Robbins today, is where attention goes, energy flows. So whatever you focus on, whatever your awareness is, whatever your attention is, that is where your energy is going. So see the image of what you do want, see the vision of what you do want, see the idea of what you do want. And if that seems impossible, just start with wild big picture thinking, you know, like what could that be like for me? And allow yourself to just go in that direction. And that will help you advance and create more momentum in the pathway that works best for your greatest benefit and that feels better. Also, another point that I didn't write in the description box, but that I would like to bring up is when people are talking or sharing negative energy with you or information that is just maybe like the bad news that they heard on the news or something that upsets them that can potentially upset you, rather than reacting to it either negatively or positively, you can be neutral. And you can put on your listener cap, you could put on that cap and just listen, right? Really, people are sharing and they just want to be heard. They just want to talk. So let them talk. And if they want you to say something, well, then they will probably let you know that they want you to say something. And if they do, then you can say, oh, well, I'm listening to you. I hear you. And it seems like you really care about that. It seems like it's important to you. And I appreciate you sharing with me. And that's it. You know, you don't have to go into the pros and cons and I'm not into that because that's negative energy or that is a message that disrupts my whatever space and my vibe. It doesn't have to be that way. It's like contrarian or combative, but just being a listener, you know, that's all that people really want when they're talking is to have someone listen to them. And if they need validation, then you can just continue listening and nod your head and just say, I hear you. Yeah. But you don't have to take that into yourself as a responsibility that you have to answer or that you have to form your own opinion or that you have to counter it or that you have to defend yourself. You can just listen. And listening is one of the greatest resources that we learn as life coaches and that will serve you enormously in all of your relationships is listening. Listening, a skill that is actually something, a fine art of developing. And truly listening and engaging their appearance and their physical positioning. Hi, Bev. Hi, Alex. So thanks to everyone who's watching. And so that was something that I personally experienced today. So consider that for yourself is the next time that you're engaging with someone else wants to share something with you, whether it is defined as good or bad news, just listen, right? And appreciate the moment of the sharing and having them share something with you that matters to them. because that is quite extraordinary and very special. And that is that could be very helpful in all your relationships. And the final point that I wanted to bring up is just to cultivate your awareness and your attention, and to tell your mind what you want it to think and how you want it to feel, and make your mind your best friend and your partner, and know that you are directing and commanding and instructing your mind to guide you. Thank you, Bev. So command your energy, command your mind, and then allow your mind to work for you, rather than you feeling like your mind is kicking you around and like it's a crazy monkey. You know, I no longer subscribe to that paradigm or belief system where the mind is a monkey, an unruly child. Because, well, not all children are unruly. You know, some are really well behaved. Have you noticed that? And are all monkeys really unruly? Have you seen a lot of monkeys in action? Maybe they're not so unruly and they're actually quite logical in their given domain and realm. But you see, we say these phrases and then we take them on as our identity, and we label ourselves or an aspect of ourselves, and then we make that aspect our identity or definition, a limiting belief and a limiting factor. And it doesn't need to be that way. You don't need to do that to yourself. So consider that your mind is your friend. Your mind is here to help you. Your mind is a remarkable, extraordinary, phenomenal tool that we don't even know what it is, but it's there. It's something that we label as a mind, but it's not the brain. It's a mind. So what is your mind for you? And can you now make it your friend, enlist it in your command? And it lovingly serves you, and it now operates for you and on your behalf in all conditions and in all circumstances, in all situations. Yeah, and as my fellow life coach friend Bev Spencer says, all emotions serve a purpose. Even when we think we're self-sabotaging, when there's a behavior that you want to eliminate and get rid of, but you still continue to do, ask that behavior as if you're talking to your right hand or your left hand, and take it, or as if you're taking a stone, and you take it and you ask it, if this is my limiting belief or my limiting behavior, what is your purpose? How are you serving me? How are you benefiting me? And that is the reason why you're still here. So if this helps, take an object, whatever is nearby, or something that you feel is particularly illustrative of the behavior or emotion that you want to master and either get rid of or shift or change or mold. It could be, if it's a beverage that you want to get rid of, like an alcohol beverage, you could take it in your hand and look at it and say, you know, like, what is your, like, what purpose are you serving in my life? How are you serving me? And it will serve, it will have a positive intent. What is your positive intent? Even in abusive relationships, you can look at the other person and ask within yourself, if not necessarily looking like literally with them in the room, but consider, what is the positive intent behind me keeping this person in my life? And that will open up a whole host of possibilities, or it will really be clear. It's obviously one thing. It's giving you a sense of security. It's giving you a sense of relationship, even if it's not real, or and it's just a temporary or artificial fix, or it's keeping you connected to someone else in your past, it's fulfilling some kind of need. So when we're holding on to that thing, it's because it's meeting an unmet need. But when you know when that need is and you realize that this item or person or thing, it will never fill that need because it can only come from within me. And so that is a whole big thing, but you are the ultimate source of meeting your needs, needing approval, needing acceptance, needing love, security, safety, the sense of success, the sense of financial well-being. Whatever that is, it stems from you within in your heart. So those are big topics. And I'm just covering the surface, skimming the surface. And I truly hope that these have helped you. So I'm so grateful to all these wonderful friends who are online right now. Thank you to all that you wonderful friends. And so those have been some of the insights from today, some of the things that I've personally become very aware of and practice today. Being the source of meeting my needs, just being a listener rather than thinking you need to say something when someone's talking to you, you can listen actively. And focusing your energy in the direction of where you do want to go, talking about what you do want, and less and less and less and about what you do not want or what's hurting you, and knowing your outcome, knowing what you do want. That is so powerful. Every day, what is my outcome for today? What are my intentions for today? What is my outcome from this gym session? What is my outcome from this moment, this meeting, this trip, this meal? Okay, and this will give you a vision, a focus, and a target that will give you a greater sense of peace of mind, satisfaction, and well-being, and personal success, personal power at its best. All right, so that's it for now. Thanks for joining, and thank you for listening, for being an active listener. You have already started practicing being an active listener, which is fantastic and awesome. Good for you. Congratulations. Pat yourself on the back. Remember to praise yourself for all the good that you're doing and that you always do. And give yourself the validation that you're looking for from other people. If you need approval from others, approve of yourself. If you want someone to tell you that you're beautiful and amazing, tell yourself you're beautiful and amazing. Remind yourself that you are enough, that you are fantastic. And whatever it is you want other people to tell you, tell it to yourself. Say it out loud, look in the mirror, and state it. Okay? So that's it for now. Personal power for you and for me and for everyone. And we are all one. So when we help ourselves, we help the world. When we help the world, we're helping ourselves. But make sure that you are grounded, centered, and complete from within, as you go out into the world to truly feel that fulfillment in all the good that you do. All right, so thanks for joining. I'm Jen from Personal Power Life Coaching. Thanks for joining, and see you soon. Bye. Mm-hmm.